You're gonna have to really run and like fucking launch that shit.
Alright. Where do I grab this? Like right here.
Just so you know, the center of gravity is like right where you're holding it, so I think that's good.
Alright.
Alright. Oh shit!
No!
Well, you kind of knew this was gonna happen. Fuck. Wait a minute. This isn't that bad.
No.
It's just the wing. I think we're good. This can be fixed.
All these tubes right here for the guide wire, this needs to be taped down.
Yeah.
For sure.
Same thing on this side. You sure rubber bands won't do the job?
I'm gonna tape it down. This too, the structural thing, those things are so prone to come out. I think it couldn't hurt to just add extra support here.
Yeah.
On tape, because look, this thing split down the middle. I think this is salvageable. It's gonna take some work, but I think it's salvageable. This is the main thing though. This is the first part that gave way. I think what happened is, once it hit it, this like wanted to come out because of the force, and it like just pulled this out. The other one completely came out. It's in here and ripped the wire. I don't even have any idea what to do about that. This little splitter cable is designed so that it can't come out. Maybe I need to take that part off and let it be able to come out. So yeah. Worst case scenario, the plug gets yanked out instead of the wire breaking. Maybe that's, if it was enough force to break this wire, it's definitely enough force to pull this up. Which is probably better, because then it doesn't break. This needs to be taped down. I don't know if it's a good idea to glue it. I think just tape. If I glue it, I won't be able to repair it. I think we need to go lower speed, 25% to 50% throttle. And definitely next time I'm gonna have the flaps installed, because I didn't have them installed today. I'm gonna have the flaps, so I think we'll be able to take off our lower speed. And you know what? I definitely need some fucking landing gear.
Yeah, definitely.
If we can have landing gear, only problem is like in the grass.
Real quick question, dirt and stuff like this, it's gonna be really stupid, but like skids, kind of like something like a helicopter would have, like,
as long as it doesn't just like,
exactly,
like poke into it.
I should probably be saying more like a sled, right? Or like an ice skate.
Well, you know what? It's a lot of weight.
You sure? I mean, I was thinking it might be less weight than wheels. Or maybe, you know what? Let me add this. Maybe if we have a flying vehicle that we can't control really well, we may as well not stick knives into it. That's not a good idea.
All right. So, landing gear for sure. Tape all around the whole fuselage. Gotta fix this wire, and we need flaps. And then more tape here to at least hold it in. I think that should do it for next time. And then it's just a matter of how we take off. Niggas saying they outside. Niggas saying they
outside. Send the attic, we gon' slot. So here are the landing gear that I 3D printed and that I'm going to test out on the actual plane. So I reinforced the plane with a bunch of tape in the beginning. Here are the flaps working. I installed some flaps so that we can get some more lift at lower speeds. Here's the switch that I used to turn them on and off. I think with all these reinforcements, it should help the plane's structural stability. And you can see I mounted the landing gear on there. Everything else works, it's in good condition, and I also reinforced the bottom of the plane with extra tape as well.
too.
Yeah.
It's been some time since last time, but I repaired the plane. And we added flaps and various other core structures.
Core structure.
So right.
All right, let's go.
There's a high chance that this is gonna fail. It's a flap. We want flaps on right now. I got the little lanyard.
Yeah.
All right,
let's do it. Yeah, it's looking great. Yo, you know, it's like,
the wheels don't work.
Remember those, like, the things they use on shoes that got wheels?
The Heelys?
Yeah, the Heelys. Remember, like, a single little crack would do it, and I imagine even smaller wheels than that.
Yeah,
I gotta throw it.
And if we're gonna throw it, how about we move over there, where it's not gonna crash and absolutely destroy itself.
Alright, so we're definitely gonna throw it.
Why don't we go on top of that hill, man?
Can we, like... Alright, let's go on top of that hill.
Just... Alright, so...
We clearly messed up. There were some miscalculations, underestimations.
Yeah, these wheels are not gonna work. They need to be bigger.
Let's go up that hill.
Let's go. So you just grab that. There you go. Right wing shot.
Yeah, we're gonna try to get this out of here.
It's working, huh?
Yeah, there
it is.
Boom.
Perfect. So we lost a little bit of structural integrity.
There you go.
Let's go. There we go. That's good.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna throw it hard this time, I promise.
All right. Wow, the propeller came off.
Yeah, I knew it felt weird. The whole propeller was loose.
Yeah.
Actually, we didn't get any damage though.
What are these?
Oh shit.
Can you start collecting stuff here?
Dude, I think we're good. We can play this one.
Are you crazy?
No. This thing goes back on. I'm pretty sure this is everything.
Okay, what about
hold
the
this?
Rest? Yeah.
I don't think there's any damage.
Yeah, so here's what we're dealing with. I think I'm gonna change the battery.
Yeah.
This battery feels low.
What about the wings? How are we doing on the wings? Nothing snapped.
I don't think anything broke.
It was just loose, right?
It just came out.
So how come it didn't turn? Like it went down, right? Like a nose.
Oh. I need another two. These little fucking vinyls.
Perfect.
Look yeah, everything's good.
What about these? We're good with that?
Yeah, everything's good.
Here, yeah, just a little debris.
No, we're good.
Nothing crazy. Wow, oh. This is actually... Oh.
This is where the damage is. No, this is even...
But tape.
That's minor.
Super glue and tape, okay.
This came off. That's not that important.
Are we gonna have to put some tape or something?
But actually, that's what's holding it. Definitely. This is definitely flyable.
Yeah, we gotta put the prop up.
Oh, I see more damage. It's minor.
So we're back in action. Reparable damage.
Yeah.
So nothing too crazy.
That's what I'm talking about. Last time it was this, we blew it up.
All I gotta do is... Wait a minute. I should be going up.
That's what I was fucking up too. I need to pull up.
Oh, okay.
All right, ready?
Yep.
Dude, this shit is really hard.
it got some more airtime, okay. That does seem a little lethal, what we just saw right there.
That was definitely a better flight, though.
Better flight, more responsive, but... Yo, dude, here's a question, right? Like, don't you think we should try to, like, at least fly the low altitude
so it doesn't do these like big nose guys.
It means easier to crash.
Really? I mean, if we just keep it like ground level.
When you have space to fall, you have more time to save.
Alright, hold up, before you touch anything, let's assess the damage.
I think it's the same damage.
Yeah, is it? Because I feel like...
No, we're good. The wings literally just came apart and that's it. I think we could go another go.
Alright.
If you say so, because I don't...
Because, like, I'm pulling up.
That doesn't help either.
So. I know. That would have been tragic.
And it will, it's down.
I pulled up, and then it's like, it just doesn't make sense. I don't know how to explain it.
So you go, it's super sensitive. You press it up to go up, or you press it down to
I'm
go
like,
down?
The elevator goes like this, so that makes you go up. So you have to go up, and like that. Dude, it's so sensitive, though.
But you think I threw it, like, maybe a little too
No,
upwards?
I actually think you were good.
Yeah.
We actually got off, and then I started going up, but it was when I was turning, it was hard to control.
How about the wind could also be affecting things up there? And do you think that maybe the...
I'd say it's mostly my controls that are fucking it up.
Yeah.
Because we got liftoff.
How about we try something? Try flying it the farthest you can, rather than the
just
highest.
Just go straight.
Yeah, go straight. Let's try to, like, keep it stable, you know? Just go back to, like... New ground flash games, so like make it as far as we can make it.
Alright, there you go. That's better.
This thing like wrapped around it. But you know, I think the extension cables help because it wasn't so like tight. Mm. That tightness ended up breaking.
When the thing in the back popped out, the metal bar popped out. Remember how that thing that lost the tape below this wing.
Yeah.
What do we got?
So, this will probably be the last flight. We got a lot of damage. I think we just need new wings and new control arms.
Mm-hmm.
They broke off. We taped it pretty badly. There's a very high chance that this is gonna fail. Also, I gotta test the motor because the ESC motor came out and it might be in the incorrect phase now.
Right. We totally missed it on the recording. I actually fucking saved it.
Such a power.
Holy fuck, that was definitely the best flight. It's good? What's coming off?
Look at this.
Oh no, we're good.
The wind, you know? For a second,
yeah, it was the wind. It was definitely, I felt that I had to counter it. So, just the tape kind of
came out a little bit. I don't know if you want to do one more flight since it's like,
yeah, one more. Dude, that was the best one.
As long as it's still operational, we keep going.
All right, we just
did that landing. When I saw that landing, I was like, don't touch it,
dude. Dude, I was trying so hard to correct it. I wish we got it on film. Fuck
yeah,
we have
okay, then
we
I
gotta like
to be...
run to this,
yeah.
Holy shit, though. Let me give you a breakdown what happened. So we fucking went up. I was like about to fucking
bank.
And then I was like, I figured out the directions and I corrected it. And then
the wind
like pushed it over.
Pushed it.
And it was, and then, it went too far up.
Yeah. That one I was like, oh no.
Yeah.
We gotta get the audience of us saying like, no.
It went too far up and then it went down and I had to like correct it. And it was about to fall.
And then you pulled
it was about
up.
To crash, and I pulled up at the last second and managed to land it.
That was great.
We are still operational, baby.
Yo, this is a trooper.
It really is.
As long as it doesn't crash into a tree, I think we're good. Tree is a true...
Without those reinforcements, though, on the bottom, it would not have lasted this long.
Yeah.
So stock plane would not have worked.
I think it's good that with like the tapes coming off, you know what I'm saying? Like it resists, you know, enough to where things don't go flying, but it also lets things move. If it was rigid, the whole thing would come out, you know?
Yeah.
Let's check the bottom. Is the bottom good? funny how you were doubting the tape. The tape worked.
It's a fucking miracle.
Yeah, that was,
that was not supposed to work.
What happened there?
He didn't have enough thrust. You have to feel it out, dude. Ah, damn it.
I didn't put more effort than in the last run.
No, I didn't put it up all the way. I think I need to put full throttle.
Oh, okay.
Why I kind of had it half. There?
Yeah. Yeah.
So this is the same problem we had before, though. We just managed to tape it down with this.
This improvements is... next time, duct tape. Duct tape. God, like that flap is so fucked.
I'm gonna glue that next time too.
What about the flap? You gonna repair that?
Dude, this is the YOLO flight. I'm ordering new wings and control arms. This is the YOLO. All right, set it up.
You wanna throw it in and do the thing? Cause that way, yeah, cause you gotta get the feel for it. That way you know if like it requires more thrust or not. All
right, is it recording?
All right, resetting.
This is the YOLO flight. I'm gonna try doing it myself.
All right.
But all right, we'll see how it goes.
Well, predictions, I think the wing's gonna come off mid-flight.
These wings are fucked, and yeah. The flap kind of broke.
Yep.
So we're gonna see.
All right. Holy shit, what's going on over there?
Wow, doing it. Amazing.
Oh, what? You're doing a fucking...
What was the purpose of that? All right, now that is absolutely completely foobar.
That means it's over.
Yeah.
It's over. Look at this.
Oh no.
It's actually over now.
All right, we got issues with like. I mean, just
everything has to be reordered.
Yeah,
but it doing it by myself is definitely doable. Actually, it wasn't that bad because then I could feel how much. You don't even need to run; like you just kind of have to like give it a little bit of throw.
If it's full thrust, full throttle, then you don't need the full thing.
Dude, it's so hard to control though.
Yeah. Let's assess the damage here because this got fucked.
Yo, the tape was actually holding this shit together, man. Look at how the wings came out. So, holy fuck, the front.
Wow.
Oh, yeller. You have to find put it down. Holy fuck.
Well, everything has to be ordered.
Yeah.
Wow.
That is tremendous.
Alright, boys, pack it up. It's over.
All right, here are like spectator suggestions for what could go better. Next time we could use duct tape reinforcing, probably like a cross reinforcing along the fuselage to prevent this from happening.
This specifically, look at the tearing. It bent and tore. That wouldn't have happened if we had like cross tape. This was a good improvement from last time. Look at what happened here. Everything kept structural integrity in this part that was taped and reinforced. The same thing happened here. Tape. This part took so many hits. This should have happened to this way faster, but look, tape.
Yeah, the wings, definitely more tape. You know what I mean? Just reinforcing on both sides.
We got some improvements here. Yeah, duct tape, definitely the usage of duct tape, but say kind of, I know you want to put a lot more, but this is kind of like not too much because that does actually have some weight. The regular tape did the job, so kind of a mixture between those two. Rubber band. Asterisk, possible, careful, might have caused this, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
this might have been snapped to the rubber band, who knows?
Yeah, the tension of the rubber band pulling on it while it hit it, I think created like a pivot point.
Yeah, actually that's a pretty good way to describe it. Yeah.
One more thing, next flight we're gonna do, we're trying to choose maybe a warmer day.
Absolutely, but also no wind day, like no
zero wind.
Nothing that affects the input from the pilot.
It definitely does. We got like 10 mile an hour winds heading this way, which is what?
And changing directions, because that one that bent it this way totally came from like that.
wind was kind of like southeast a little bit. It was going southeast, 10 mile an hour winds. Wasn't too bad. I think it was doable. But you know what really fucked me was when I went up.
Yeah.
That perspective loss, and it changes the direction, and now I needed to go the opposite way. That didn't trigger in my brain.
How about in order to protect against that, also try to keep it straight? Like, you really have to, like, it doesn't matter how good your piloting skills are when handling the wind. If you can't fly straight, we're fucked. You know what I mean? We're just gonna
what made that difficult, though, is the wind. And then compensating for the wind forced it to kind of move. I overcompensated.
Well, how about a test plan? What is the course you want to do? You want to do, like, a easy takeoff, 100 meters and landing? How about that? Or maybe do one, then turn around, one, and then turn around and land.
Yeah,
how
I think
that?
Like kind of like a track field type of shape.
Yeah.
Where, like, you do touch and goes where it's straight, turn around, land.
Sounds good. I think that's a pretty good plan.
Yeah.
I mean, look, I would say stick to this. Honestly, look, our repair skills improve. 4 flights after, like, you know, except one that landed properly, but the other 3.
Dude, I wish we got that on camera.
Yeah,
that was so clutch. Right at the end, it was like, whoop, and landed.
Yep. Oh, one last question I wanted to ask you. Do you think that maybe have, like, you know, moving the throttle midair when you see the wind coming and actually pushing and maybe taking away the throttle and just going and gliding with it, and then once you restabilize, because if you have full throttle and the wind changes it into a nosedive, guess what? You're fucking going full throttle down. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, like, I actually was trying to compensate for that. Yeah, I think I stalled.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Like, let's try to learn how to glide this thing. You know what I'm saying? Maybe go full throttle. How about that's a 100 meter? The full throttle one will be the whole course,
yeah.
But the 100 meter, take off, glide, see if
cut
it can
the
glide.
Engine,
yeah.
And then just glide.
Yeah, there you go. The whole goal is not to stall. You know, we can do that, then hey, next time we'll probably be way better off.
See you next time.
Yeah.